We are standing here in front of the absolute masterpieces of the Egyptian department in Leiden. These statues are so special because they are over life size, and yet they represent a private person. This was the treasurer of King Tutankhamun. We all know Tutankhamun, but this is one of his very high officials, and his name is Maya. He was in charge of the finance department, but even more than that, he was also in charge of interior affairs in Egypt. Because Tutankhamun was a young boy, what could he do? He needed his senior advisors, and Maya was one of the very important ones. This statue was acquired here in Leiden in 1828. It came together with a lot of other statues, reliefs, inscriptions, including a statue of Maya's wife, Merit. And yet nobody knew where they came from. It was just a private collection. You could buy that and bring it to the Netherlands. But of course, we want to know more about this fascinating person. And we have discovered so much. We have found out, when you read the inscriptions, that this was an official who worked in Memphis, the Egyptian capital, very close to Cairo. And he put these statues in his tomb, which was made for one of the cemeteries of ancient Memphis, a cemetery close to the present-day village of Saqqara. Now, in 1975, our museum went to Saqqara to start a new excavation project, and we have relocated the tomb of Maya, and we have found the bases where this statue and that of his wife were put up in antiquity, and where the statues were removed around 1825. So now we know a lot more about this person. These statues were put up in the tomb of Maya, where he was buried together with his wife, Merit, and other relatives. We found the bases where these statues were standing, and they were in front of the inner part of the tomb. The tomb had an open courtyard, and then you entered the cult chapels. The chapels where relatives or friends of the dead persons went in to bring food offerings. And the statues were there as, you might say, the receivers of these offerings. The Egyptians, in fact, believed that the spirit of the deceased would come down from the heaven or from come up from the underworld, the netherworld, to live inside the statue so that he could personally accept these offerings. And so you might say the statue is very important for the survival of this spirit. It is the temporary abode of the spirit. But you can't say that it is a portrait of the deceased. For all we know, Maya may have been an old man and maybe very ill when he died. But a statue would never show an old person. It is an ideal age, ideal beauty, forever young. And that's how you want to go to the hereafter. The high position of these two persons, Maya and Merit, shows from the details of these sculptures. As any very high official, Maya is wearing his best clothing, finely pleated linen garments, and also this beautiful wig that he has on his head. We can still see a bit of black paint on the wig, as there is red paint on his lips. These statues were colored. The wife of Maya, Merit, has also a characteristic appearance. She has a very long garment that is going down to her ankles, and she has a longer wig than her husband, a very finely plaited wig. In her hands, she has a symbol of her office. She was a songstress, a musician, of the temple of Amun. Amun was again the highest god of the Egyptian pantheon after Tutankhamun took over the power. He restored the old tradition, the old religion. And what she is wearing, or carrying in her hand, is a so-called menat. A menat is a heavy counterweight, which was hanging at the back of the neck, to balance the heavy necklace, which is part of this object. And that was used in the cult of many gods and goddesses. It produced a rattling sound. You could shake it in your hand to accompany the songs you are performing during the temple cult. So she was a priestess, or at least a musician, in the cult of several Egyptian gods. And that's what we also can read from the inscription on her skirt. It is a very common type of inscription, an offering formula, which means that the deceased is asking the Egyptian gods to give them plenty in the hereafter, to give them food and drink and other things. And then it always says, and this will be for the benefit of the deceased. And then it says, she is the beloved wife of Maya, and she is a musician of Amun. That's what we can read there in that column of hieroglyphs. And we have now been able to determine how unique these statues are. None of the tomb owners of Saqqara, and we have found many tombs now, had statues of this quality or of this size. When you look at his body, you see it's rather full-bodied. It shows an official who is well-to-do, who has been able to put on some weight. That was the beauty ideal of the ancient Egyptians. But the shape of his body and of his face also reminds a bit of the artistic style of the Amarna period, the period of Akhenaton, Tutankhamun's father. And we all know that in his days there was an artistic revolution in Egypt, not just a religious revolution, because only the sun god was worshipped, but also an artistic revolution, greater realism, a certain degree of expressionism. And we can see something of that in these statues. But it is much milder, it's much more elegant. And that is characteristic for the reign of Tutankhamun or Tutankhamun's successor, Horemheb. It's possible that these statues were made under the latter reign of Horemheb. And Horemheb was a good friend and colleague of Maya, because Horemheb had been in charge of the external affairs of Egypt during Tutankhamun. And the two colleagues, the two high officials, constructed their tombs side by side in Saqqara. And we have found both of these tombs. So we can compare and we can see that these people, who were the absolute masters of Egypt, in fact, not next to the pharaoh, but above the pharaoh, that they were able to get the very best sculptors to make their statues, to make the wall reliefs of their tombs. And, as I said, parts of these fantastic monuments have come to Leiden, and they belong to the absolute masterpieces of our collection.